हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम सुषमा विस्पुति हियर अगेन टू डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ द डीबीएमएस. सो टुडे आई विल कवर हियर ऑल द रिमेनिंग कंस्ट्रेंट. राइट, इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द फॉरेन की कंस्ट्रेंट. सो टुडे वी विल हैव डिस्कशन ऑन नॉट नल कंस्ट्रेंट, यूनिक की कंस्ट्रेंट एट कॉलम लेवल एंड टेबल लेवल. Right, and check constraint syntax at the column level and table level. So today I will cover in detail with example the syntax for all these constraint. So you know what is not null constraint? When we want to make any field mandatory in the form, right? So while designing the database, right, for example for creating the table itself, you can assign this not null constraint to the particular field that you want mandatory in the table, right? Means while insert operation, that value should be filled by the end user, right? So for example here, if you want to make this name field of employee, right, employee name should be inserted by the end user. So here how you can apply this constraint in the while creating the table. So you declare this field name. Name is the field name, character, data type and size you can mention as usual. Then this syntax is same as the other constraint syntax. You can use your constraint name, right? It is optional like your other constraint syntax, right? And then you can mention here by giving space not null, right? So this syntax will create name field with the not null constraint, right? Means this field never be empty, right? So here if you describe the structure of the table, you can find the name field is created with the not null constraint here, right? Name field is created with the not null constraint that you can see in the describe table, right? I hope you are clear with this. Then next is the unique key constraint, right? You know, unique key is like your primary key, right? But the main difference between primary key and unique key is that, right, your unique key can be null, right? In one table, there can be multiple unique key fields, right? But only one primary key will be there, right? So primary key actually we define for the unique identification of the record, and my primary key never be null. But here there can be multiple unique key fields in the one table, right? So you know, in practical also some fields we need practically also we need some field, those should be unique. For example, your mobile number, right? So mobile number is the one example of the unique field. If some of the student don't have mobile, then your mobile number field can be empty for that particular student, right? Similarly, your passport ID, right? Then Aadhaar card ID, right? So all this field you can define as a unique key in the table. You know, all these fields are unique for every user, right? So this can be defined as a unique in the table. So one table can have multiple unique keys here. So you can remember, student, these are the example of unique keys: passport ID, right? Then your mobile number and your Aadhaar card ID, right? So Aadhaar card also is the another example of unique field. So here we will see the syntax for creating this unique key, right? Primary key will be only one field, will be primary key of the table, and that we select for the unique identification of the record, right? So these are the example of the unique keys. So here my example is for the ID. ID we have created. How we can create this unique key? So we will discuss here the column level syntax, right? So ID, as usual, you can declare the field ID, its data type and size, and by giving space only you can mention here unique word, right? The spelling UNIQUE, right? Here keyword is not there. Only you can say this ID, I want to make it as a unique, right? But logically, my ID should be primary key. Just to learn the syntax, right, we have taken this ID as a unique field here. Right. Similarly, if you want here location as a unique key, right? Also, location will be unique for every user, for every employee, right? So you can just give this space and you can say unique here. My language is not case sensitive, so you can also write here small, no problem, right? So here only by giving space you can write the unique. So my location will create as a unique key in the table. So one table can have multiple unique key and this can be null, right? So you can remember this distance. Now next week we'll discuss the syntax at table level syntax, right? This is another example of the column level syntax, right? Location we have declared with the unique key constraint, right? So this is another syntax for the declaring the unique key like your other constraint. So location is my field name, its data type, and then you can mention constraint name. So again, this part is optional that we discussed in the previous slide, right? So constraint name, unique, right? So in future, if you want to remove this constraint, you can use this name, right? Because this name is given by you, you can easily remember this and you can remove if it is required in the future, right? So this location field will create with the unique key constraint, right? Means what? Whenever you will insert the data, only unique value will be allowed to the location field here. Then next, we can discuss here table level syntax, right? Again, the syntax is same as the other constraint. After declaring all the columns, right? Here, I want to make this location field as a unique key, right? So here I have given comma, means I have declared location, and at last you can mention like others constraint name, unique location. So location field of this table, right? In bracket we are mentioning location. The location can be located in anywhere here in the declaration part, right? Here I am mentioning ki location I want unique in the table, right? So this is another example of the unique constraint that is at the table level syntax, right? So I hope student you are clear with this. The next is the check constraint. You know that check constraint is used for applying the business rule, right, to the column. For example, the best example I think we have discussed previously also in short, if you want to apply the business rule for the banking application, minimum balance should be 500 in the account of the customer. Minimum balance should be 500. So that constraint of this minimum balance you can apply here, right? While creating the table itself with the help of check constraint syntax, right? So here is the example. So we will discuss here the column level syntax and table level syntax, right? So here for gender field I want to apply the check constraint ki gender should be in the M and F only, right? So gender field should accept only two values, that is capital M or capital F, right? It should be capital, right? So when we compare the string or data, it is case sensitive. You remember, student, right? So this should be capital M and capital F, right? So how you can apply this constraint with the help of syntax? Declare your column as usual, my column name, then data type and size, then check, right? In check, in bracket, you can mention gender in. In is my operator, set operator. In you can mention multiple field that you want to match with the field, right? While inserting the record. So here, gender in M comma F, right? So this is my check constraint syntax. If you want to apply the check constraint for the salary field, for example, salary should be greater than 10,000 or salary never be negative. Right. So my check constraint will be here I should not be comma. After declaring the field, you can mention check. My salary should be positive. By mistake, if somebody will try to insert the negative salary, right, it will not allow, right? So insert operation will not allow to enter the negative value. So check in bracket, you can mention my field name is salary here. Salary should be greater than zero, right? So this is my check constraint for the salary field. Similarly, for minimum balance, if you are designing the banking application database, right? So you can apply the minimum balance constraint with the help of the check constraint. I hope, student, you are clear with this syntax. This is column level syntax. While declaring the column itself, by giving space, you use here check word. Check is the keyword here. Another example here, right? The same example for the table level syntax. So we can discuss here table level syntax. Constraint, constraint name, after declaring all the column, at last you can mention constraint, constraint name, check in bracket, which field of this table you want to apply check constraint, that is gender, right? So in bracket you can mention gender in M comma F, right? So this is my table level syntax, right? Then this is another example, right, with some string operators, right? So also you can learn here some of these string operators. Those are available in the SQL language. So here my problem statement says what? Create an employee table with the following constraint, right? So what are these constraint? Data values being inserted into the column name must start with the capital letter EID, and data values being inserted into the column name department should be uppercase only. Right. So here two constraint we need to apply, right? My employee ID should start with the EID, capital EID, right? And my employee name and department name, actually employee name is not given here in the problem statement. I'm saying here employee name and department name should be in the capital letters only. Many form you might have seen, registration forms, where only capital letters are allowed, right? So here my employee name and department name should be in the uppercase letter. Right? So how you can apply this constraint with the help of check constraint syntax? These are the column level syntax. So ID, varchar, my employee ID should start with the EID. So here you can use after check, here we mention the criteria, right? So condition ID like, how you want your ID like is the operator, right, that we use for the string matching. Right, like operator is used for the pattern matching. So here my string is for EID mod. Right, why it is mod here? Mod is the wildcat character we use with the like operator always. Right, so mod indicate what here? This wildcat character indicate what? After EID there can be any letter or number. Right. So not only neighbor means any value will be there after EID. So mod indicate any number of values and any value. It can be character or numeric also. That is the meaning of mod here. Right? So EID, my string will start with the EID, and after EID there can be any value. Right? So with the help of like operator, you can add such a constraint also, and you can retrieve data also with the help of like operator, right? So another constraint is what? My name should start with the uppercase, right? So again, for name field, I want to apply this constraint check name equal to upper. Upper is the inbuilt string function available in the your SQL family, right? So Oracle, in Oracle, MySQL also there, right? So these are the string functions. Upper is the inbuilt function, right? And in bracket, you can mention that field name you want up in the uppercase, right? So similarly, department I want in the uppercase. So DPT equal to upper in bracket, you can mention the field name that you want in the uppercase, right? I hope, student, you are clear with one more constraint we have applied here for the gender field. So gender I want in only MFF that we discussed in the previous slide. Same we have applied here. So one table can have multiple check constraints. You can observe here, right? So as per your application requirement, you can apply different business rule with the help of check constraint. So in future, student, if you have forgot to apply the any constraint and you want to add that constraint, right? So that you can do with the help of alter table statement. While discussing alter table syntax, also I told you we can add the constraint to the table with the help of alter table statement, right? So here is the syntax, right, for adding the primary key into the table, right? So how you can do this? Alter table, table name, right? Add primary key. So you can mention here a constraint name. My constraint is the primary key, and in bracket you can mention which field of that table, which field of the employee table you want to make it as a primary key. So ID is the field name, right? So before this alter option, my ID is null. Here, if you see the structure of the table, my id is the null value, means the id will allow the null value, but after executing this table statement, my result will be this. So here, if you observe, these changes are there, right? This is the result of my alter statement, right? So after executing alter table statement, right, my structure of the table will change this, right? So not null constraint will be assigned to this id field, right? I hope you are clear with this. Again, like your add option, there is a drop option, right? So in future, if you want to drop this constraint, right, either primary key constraint, foreign key constraint, you can do with the help of alter table statement. So how you can do this? So alter table, table name, drop primary key. So primary key is one in every table, that's why no need to mention here the field name. Why? Because every table is having only one primary key, so it will remove this primary key from the table. So before this alter statement, this is my actual table where my id is the primary key and the result of this statement is this. So not null value is removed from this, right? So I hope, student, you are clear with this. And last, here we can discuss how you can set the default value to one of the field. Many times you require to assign the default value to the field in the table. So here, for example, by default, I want to set the department name as a computer, right? So whenever I will insert data into the table, then I will skip the computer department name, right? So by default, it will take computer for the skip field, right? Then here again, if most of the students' location is Pune, for example, right? So by default, this location I can set here the Pune. So when you will insert the data, you can skip this field. So for the skip field, it will insert the Pune value, right? So here is the example how you can set this default value, right? So here we have declared the table and location field by default I want to set with the Pune, right? So just you can mention here after declaring this field, the default, my location is the default. Default is the keyword here, right? And after writing this default, give the space and in single quote, if it is a string value, you can write that value into the single quote. So Pune is my default value I want to set for the location, right? So this will set as a default value for the location field. So when you will insert data into the table, here is the statement for inserting the data. I am inserting new record into the employee table. So what field I am inserting here? ID, name, department, age and salary. Location I have skipped, right? Location field I have skipped here, means I am not inserting the location value. So values 101 is my employee ID, name is Ajay, computer department, age is 25 and salary is 50,000, right? So which record will insert it into the table? If you observe, by default, my insert operation has taken Pune as the default value here in the location, right? Because Pune we have not inserted in the insert statement, only till salary we are inserting the value. So Pune is taken here automatically because my default value is Pune. Right? So student, I hope you are clear with this. So this is my complete record that we have inserted with the help of insert table statement. I hope you are clear with this syntax of default value. And again, there can be multiple fields where you can set the default value, right? Thank you.